I sat up last night for about an hour and a half and just cried like a baby. And I thought about last week and the 4th of July weekend and the sacrifices that are made every day so that we can be free. And I thought about these homecomings, and I thought about these people who come home to their families. And the story of the prodigal son came to mind. And I couldn't help but think, we have the ability of video cameras and movies and all these things to capture all of these moments. But I wonder what that reunion was like between the prodigal son and his father. Because you see, the difference in these videos, as powerful and as touching as they are, is these soldiers served the country. And they came home with their heads held high, proud of what they had done. Yet the prodigal son found himself lost, alone, broken, and with no other options but to go home defeated. Or so he thought. You see, we all know the story of the prodigal son who demanded his inheritance early, left home, went to fill his oats, live the young life, do all of those things that you and I see on a daily basis. Yet the prodigal son found out that living a life for yourself does not bring true peace, does not give you satisfaction that you search after. For the prodigal son was willing to come home even if it was to be a slave. Yet the father had a different plan. You see, the father just wanted his son back. And I have to imagine that the reunion was so different than what the son had anticipated. You see, I imagine the son on his way home, afraid, scared, worried, hurting, and he just knew that when the father greeted him, he would greet him with scolding him and with treating him as if he had taken everything which he had and just blown it, which he had. Son was afraid. Son was hurting. But the father didn't care. For you see, the father didn't hold accounts of the wrongs. For you see, the father didn't have a checklist of things that he had to do or say to be restored, just to admit and to repent. Home. There was a message on Facebook just a few days ago. I think you saw it, Jesse. From a friend from high school. I was helping with the Van Boost organization. This person decided that they wanted to get out of town. They wanted to go live their own life and do their own thing. Here we are a year, year and a half later. And the message on Facebook says, "I've made so many mistakes. And I'm so hurting. And I just need to come home and find God's forgiveness. You see, when you get to that moment when there's nothing else left to do, God isn't waiting to punish you with a rod. I simply replied back that I was praying for, and that I know that even though it feels like we run so far from God, He's as close as a whisper. And all we need to do is just whisper His name. He's there. Today I just wanted us to look at us. Are we in a place where we need to come home? I mean, it would be easy for us, and I will admit, this was kind of a thought process of mine last night. Who am I talking to? Today I'm talking to people who have been in the church and served the church faithfully for their entire lives. I'm talking to people who have got more years in ministry than I am alive. Why would I need to tell them to come home? Why would I need to tell someone who has served the church and been in the church their entire lives and has been faithful? Why would they need to hear, come home? For all have sinned, come short of the glory of God. All we like sheep have gone astray. Even in my life, I daily look at who I am and ask the Lord to forgive me and to cleanse me and to restore me and to make me new again. Some of us, maybe we haven't been faithful. Some of us, maybe we haven't been in church our entire lives. Some of us, maybe just had a few early experiences with the Lord, but have thought maybe it would be better if we did it on our own. And we find ourselves hurting and confused. I want to encourage you today to come home. Find a place of rest in the Savior. Know that it doesn't mean that life is going to transform and become perfect. Doesn't mean that all of our troubles are just going to be washed away and we're never going to hurt again. Sometimes we hurt. But I would rather hurt in the arms of my Father, resting in Him, than I would to ever feel like I was doing it on my own. I just want to challenge you this morning. Maybe even to take a moment to bow your head and to close your eyes. Would you do that with me this morning? And ask yourself, where am I in my walk with Him? Maybe I'm okay. Maybe the relationship is there, and I know that I'm serving the Savior, and I'm living my life for Him. But even in that, are we trying to walk on our own? Sometimes we just need to trust Him to come home and to restore and to reestablish the relationship. Say, I don't know, I'm not right with the Lord. been saved, and I've walked with him before, and I've messed up. I've really stepped away. I really need to come home. I want you to know that there's a church here that will love you and pray with you, encourage you. Doesn't matter who you are. We will love you. As the entire church stands even now, would you stand with me, church? As we begin to sing this song, I want to ask you, if that's you today in this place and you just need to come home and rest in the Savior today, I'm just going to ask you to come around these altars one more time.
Would you come pray with us?